guy in the back, in the middle. What's your name?
Nick.
Nick, tell me about your upbringing. Were you a David from the time you were little?
Absolutely. I grew up in a trailer in the holler, so if I wanted to make something out of myself, I had to go and get it for myself. I mean, I was the first person in my family to go to college, so I learned it by doing it. I grew up poor in southeastern Kentucky. You know, we had food stamps, so I always took the schooling as like my way to get out. And now I'm the public defender in my county. I had two dreams, to be a lawyer and to be on Survivor. And here I am with both of those.
Cooler story.
You know, David not only slew Goliath in the Bible, he ended up becoming a king too, so.
That's right.
Woo! The story don't stop with David versus Goliath.
Yeah.
I feel a matchup here. All right, Goliath.
Stop it.
I promise they're not doing as good as us.
I really think that there's a lot of really cool people on that tribe.
Yeah.
So, like, I'm not rooting, like, against them.
Yeah.
I hope they go through hell.
You hope they're what?
I hope they go through hell.
It's very easy to avoid work if you're good at it.
Here's a pretty decent one.
I don't want to waste my energy building the shelter.
Holy crap. It stopped raining. What? Just go find firewood?
Cool. I'm on Survivor. The only thing on my mind is scheming and plotting, and I gotta find my flock of sheep.
Survivor's awesome.
Yeah, no, this is cool.
Let's stay here, bro.
Sounds like a good idea.
It's very easy to get people to trust you on Survivor. It's almost too easy.
As soon as I heard you say something, I'm like, yeah, she's probably from Kentucky.
Yeah.
Or, oh,
it
yeah.
Definitely worked out in our favor.
Yeah.
For sure.
Hopefully we don't lose
right
away.
For real.
Yeah, for real, for real.
If you really want to make things official and make that person feel like you got a good bond, your alliance has to have a name.
We need, like, the alliance.
Like, what are you thinking?
I'll think of something.
Okay, think of something. I'm not real smart about something.
What about Thoroughbred, Jeff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I can in this game, I want to name all the alliances, just because I'm out here to win $1 million, but I'm out here to have fun, too.
All right, go. Yeah.
All right.
If everybody else is talking about, you know, their parents' domestic abuse, then everybody's crying, and it's not really how I usually talk to people. I'm just a guy that, like, didn't want to open up. Well, I have this story. I really didn't feel comfortable sharing it. It's personal, and it's for me and, like, my brothers and sisters and my family. But when everybody in my tribe is talking about their most traumatic events, I feel like I can actually let my guard down.
Guys, I was wanting to tell y'all something. I don't know, it's just hard for me to open up. And so, like, you know, when we were, like, saying our stories, you know, there is something about me that I just didn't talk about yet. And basically, where I come from, like, we all have somebody close who's, like, you know, had drug problems. I was just so scared to talk about it because I don't want, like, my mother to look bad, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, to lose my mom to something like that, it's so sad to me. I mean, she overdosed like, 3. That was so...
Sorry,
like, I miss her so much. This is, like, all I've been thinking about.
You knew the moment was
going to
be here.
Telling her story again, so brave. And I feel like, you know, I feel like I've been keeping things from you all, and
you could have held that in until the very end.
I'm sorry I did.
You know,
you know, but
it's
like,
okay.
Don't be sorry.
Don't be sorry.
Don't be.
Don't be sorry.
Since I have shared my story, you know, it really feels like there's a weight off of me. You know, I really need to talk about my personal struggles as well. I do, because, you know, I never hardly cry anymore, and I think it's because my mom isn't here. Because she's always the person I would call. And being able to open up to my tribe mates, she would have been proud of me for that.
I think the storm has bring good things for us.
Yeah, I believe
so. Even though we're, like, super wet, it made us bond.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. I think when I opened my heart to them, it really made a difference. I think it kind of forms a bond, and it'll help me grow closer to all these people, and all of them I need at this point.
It's okay if I ran and got some bamboo real fast.
You want to now?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Slow down a bit.
If you don't mind being in the rain.
Christian, I can help you.
I'm not in the loop on the decision-making.
Me neither. We were about 2 hours away from having to travel. And I had no idea. Nobody's ever come to me.
Right.
Dude, I know I was the one.
That's really bad.
Well, I'm glad we didn't go to tribal, because the plan was to vote out Nick, which I didn't want to lose Nick. I mean, I didn't want to vote him out at all. I actually like him a lot, personally. We get along well. And also, the fact that we didn't have to have a vote means that that we can sort of have this sort of ambiguity of alliances still. Whereas once we do vote, that's when it's clear cut. That's where we know where everyone stands. I feel that bottom line, one of the girls has to go if we have to go.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Awesome. Now we can hurry up. We're on the same page. Each new day I get out here is a blessing, because I was only supposed to get three. So I'm either going to win or I'm going to die trying. I've always felt a connection with Christian. You know, we're like JT and Steven from Survivor Token Sheen. JT was like a country boy from Alabama, and Steven's like a genius.
I'm going to flip it. Okay, put it down for a second. One second, let me rotate it and try. Okay, go ahead, lift it up.
Between the two of us, we really got to look out for each other. So I think it's time for some more alliance making.
You need to come up with like an alliance name.
Alliance name?
Yeah.
See, you are from Kentucky?
Yeah.
And
Baltimore. Dude, we could be the Mason-Dixon line. The Mason-Dixon line runs right over top of Maryland and right over top of Kentucky. That's a good alliance name. We're Mason-Dixon.
Team Mason-Dixon. Team Mason-Dixon, all right. What's up, fist bump?
But
Team Mason-Dixon,
Team
virtual fist bump.
I think the Mason-Dixon is here for the long haul.
All hell just broke loose.
How?
So, Lyrsa, Elizabeth, and Gabby know I'm talking to you about the plan to eliminate Jess.
I say we just get Lyrsa out and stay strong.
So, at this point, Nick and I are weighing out, should we get rid of the consensus target versus making a bigger move at this very first vote, which is an inherently riskier proposition. Either way, Mason-Dixon! The Mason-Dixon Alliance is in a power position. This is a really big decision.
All of you are nodding yes, the votes are organized. Nick, it's impossible somebody doesn't know what's happening, at least one person.
The way I see it, this game is built on deceit. So that makes trust rare, and it puts trust as a premium.
You also have to weigh that against what is good for the tribe, because the more you come back here, the more likely it's you going home.
Yeah, there's absolutely balance. I mean, everybody can trust Mother Teresa. I don't think she could run that challenge today, so trust isn't enough. I mean, we're going up against the Goliath tribe. Like, their women are 6.5 foot tall, I'm pretty sure.
Second person voted out of David versus Goliath. Jessica.
Jude. Okay, that little far away, I can actually see.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Hey, Mason.
What's up, Dixon?
Dude.
Mason Dixon just pulled the best move we could possibly pull, because we are right in the middle, right where we want to be. We got the girls who think that we're in a five-person alliance with them. And then we got B and Davey and Carl who are completely blindsided and don't want to go home. So that puts the Mason-Dixon line right in the middle.
Because now we've broken the game apart into a million pieces.
Yep.
So we have to put them back together in a way where we're not targeted.
Exactly.
Okay.
I want to try to start throwing Gabby under the bus a little bit if I can. And the beauty of the situation is nobody suspects me and Christian were actually behind this. So I want to make them think it's Gabby's fault that Jessica's gone. But the truth is, if we lose again, Mason-Dixon's going to decide who goes home again.
I like you and I trust you, and to be honest, I don't feel betrayed by anybody but Gabby. She always acts like she's like worried about herself.
She's the vulnerable.
She always cries a lot.
I'd take her out next if it was
I would
if
too.
I had the opportunity.
By her as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the time is could be right to get her out. Mm-hmm. Beast's telling me how dangerous Gabby is, and I'm thinking, yeah, that sounds great for me, because I wanted to pin all the blame on Gabby and keep Mason-Dixon safe. So everything went together perfectly.
You know what really scared me? It was how quick freaking Gabby got just to the route.
That's what I'm saying. And the whole time.
That scared me to death.
She scares me.
Me too.
Yeah. If we have Christian, we got the numbers. Without Christian, we don't.
I think we would have Christian.
Because with us, it's four. We need Christian.
The only thing that worries me is Christian and Gabby are close. But he's part of Mason-Dixon. He's like my number one. And I want to make sure that I'm his number one. So if I can get Gabby out of here, I'm going to do it.
Triple Tribe. Your name is Jabini. The same Jabini. Breakdown. Right. Three former Goliaths, Natalie, Mike, and Angelina, and two former Davids with Lyrsa, hands on her hips, and Nick.
Yep. This is the mellow version.
No way.
It wasn't a few hours into this tribe where I saw a crack, and its name was Natalie. So even though Natalie's bossiness is tough to listen to, it's almost like the sweet music to my ears, because I know it's not just tough on me, it's tough on everybody.
She drives me crazy.
Yeah. Well, you feel like she could go next?
I mean, it's a longer conversation. We'll have time to talk about it.
Well, I get a good vibe from you, for sure.
I get a good vibe from you as well.
My initial goal coming into this situation was just to chill out, try not to play too fast and too hard, because that's what I love to do. But I know there's no way a David's gonna win this game playing with only Davids. And I see the opportunity to build a relationship with Mike.
But I really would like for us to work together.
I'd love to, too.
Like, start in lines or something.
Yeah, I'd love that.
Okay, awesome.
All right.
I really like Nick. He seems very unpretentious, very salt of the earth.
You want to name one or what?
Wouldn't that be awesome? All right, let's get it. Let's take a second to think about it. Like, and then we'll have a come up with a good one.
I was thinking the rock stars.
Right, it's
the movie, if you like it. We can do this.
Nice. So I'm happy to flirt with him to, like, create that bond.
And you really don't think anyone on your side has an idol?
I really don't.
Yeah. Well, the person who has the idol on my side is Dan.
You pretty sure he does?
Oh, I know he does.
Nothing would make me happier than if this Rockstar Alliance bore fruit. But I have more at risk right now than he does, because the Goliaths do have the numbers. So we'll see if I can live up to that alliance.
Yeah, the Rockstar.
Ah! Guys, you don't have to be out here.
Let's
say more. We're okay.
The elements have been crazy. Like, we can't even make a fire. All the wood is wet. We can't eat rice. We can't do nothing. I mean, this is the real deal. We're not playing Survivor Light this season.
John comes in. It's a showdown right now between David and Goliath. John for the win for Tiva. Oh, just missed.
Oh, you hit Ren. You hit Ren. This is you.
This is it. This is gotta be
it. I feel it.
Here it
Nick
is.
For the win. And he's got it. Jabini wins reward. A dozen eggs. Closer and closer. Immunity.
Oh my God! Thank you.
Sending Jabini to tribal council for the first time.
That jacket.
Y'all know what I'm writing down. I mean, we're gonna vote Lyrsa tonight.
I want that jacket. That members only jacket. You gotta get it now, or you're out of time.
I'm not stealing anybody's stuff or anything like that.
Well, how you feel about giving up your jacket?
My jacket?
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm taking my jacket away from
you. Okay, so the jacket is worth a million?
Are you trying to, like, bully me or something?
No, I just asked a question. It's not a bullying.
It seems like it. I know we're playing a game, but some things are just crossing the line. If somebody is in a position of power and they use that power to coerce or threaten somebody into doing something that they don't want to do, that's bullying in my opinion, and I don't tolerate bullying. Mally's, like, trying to intimidate me into leaving my jacket. Yeah, Mally told me that jacket worth $1 million to you.
Are you kidding me? She said that?
Yeah. She was trying to get me to steal your jacket.
Steal mine? Are you kidding me?
I think Natalie should go because she's unbearable. But on this Jabini tribe, the cards are definitely stacked against me. I mean, there's three Goliaths, there's two Davids. So Lyrsa and I, we're in big trouble.
There it is.
Yes. But Mike, trust me, he's my fellow rock star. So I'm hoping we just get 4 votes on Natalie today. Me and Mike come back to camp tonight, have a big air jam session, and we're gonna be sailing pretty.
Everybody's getting along really well. Nick, where do you fall in this?
Today, I talked to Natalie. She don't care what I have to say. All she's worried about is jackets.
You can make a preacher cuss.
Sixth person voted out a survivor, David versus Goliath. Natalie, need to bring me your torch?
There's
an Emmy.
It was a perfect travel in my book. Natalie goes home, and Angelina looks like a fool in front of everybody. If Angelina will do that for a jacket, imagine what she'll do for $1 million.
As far as the game goes, she would cut you.
She's going too hard. But Angelina's sealing her own fate with this kind of shenanigans. And I know she's a sketchball now. I know it. And I think it really opened Mike's eyes. She might flip on a dime, looks
she
like.
She definitely
turn on a,
flip
dime.
On a dime.
If we had to go to tribal again, we could get out Angelina, and it wouldn't be no skin off our backs.
Davey got to pick it up.
Get those kebabs.
Nick for the win. Yeah! He's got it. Javini wins reward. Wow. Wins immunity. Safe from tribal council. Javini knows what's coming. Tribal council for Javini, where one of the four will be voted out.
Yeah, it sucks to see her go. And I mean, I like her, you know, but we weren't like super
tight or
anything.
And there was no question in my mind.
Yeah. I'm selling a bag of goods to Angelina, no doubt. I don't have any desire to work with her because I don't trust her as far as I can throw her. I mean, she just thinks that she's just running the whole show. And that's not true at all. The truth is, I'll probably just discuss it with Mike, my fellow rock star, and whatever we think suits us best is what we'll do.
Just talk to me like a wise man. What kind of fish you doing?
I just worry, it's like, obviously this is good for Clearson's game.
Yeah.
And it's good for your game. For my game, it's more, you know, here's the thing. If the Davids get together and start just picking off Goliath after Goliath after Goliath, it's like, then I'm just boning my own game. Do you know what I mean?
I do have a lot of faith in Mike, and I trust him. At this point, I feel like Mike's best friend. I think we could go deep in this game and have fun playing it. So today, my agenda is convincing Mike that it's a great move for both of us to get out of Angelina.
I don't know. What do you think's best for us?
Well, the safe part of me says Lyrsa.
Uh-huh.
Because I feel like Lyrsa's not, like...
She's not going to be a threat to anybody.
Yeah, and also, I do think there is some upside to voting out Angelina, so I'm really torn.
It's almost like a free shot to take out
in this game.
Nick, is this a bit of a roll of the dice that I hope we're making the right decision and that if we merge, our assumptions about what is happening are correct?
Absolutely. It could be like a war coming in, and right now I'm picking the brothers and sisters I'm fighting beside and fighting with, not fighting again.
I'll cut to the chase, Jeff.
Yeah, I got a plan. She's got a plan. I think we all got a plan. For me personally, I'm here for this tribe. The David and Goliath stuff is over.
So your pitch is, I don't care about tribal alliances.
Absolutely.
To get rid of me would be an absolute mistake.
It would be a mistake. You'd be wasting a good relationship that you can use later in the game.
I'll go to bat for Nick. Can I jump in? Is that okay?
Yeah, sure.
I think Nick is someone who's a pleasure to be around. He helps around camp. You can look into his, like, piercing Wilson blue eyes, and you can see what he's thinking. To have someone who brings that honor to the game is super valuable. And so, just wanted to add
Thank
that
you.
To what you already
I appreciate
said.
That.
Yeah, of course.
Lyrsa, what do you make about that? Seventh person voted out. Lyrsa, need to bring me your torch?